in the middle of the song there, and Ray decided to go and look for his comb. It's like Mick Jagger just going off the stage, isn't it, with the Rolling Stones, just to look, you know, just to put a fucking pie in the oven. This is where we play on a Saturday, this wall here. There's a man in the news agents there, look at him. Do his head in every Saturday. No. We covered all that with flags to draw attention to ourselves. And then we get a lot of people coming out of the pubs here, you know, hen parties, stag do's and that, and they say things like, you know, I'll give you £20, can we play Wonderwall? So I say, yeah, for 20 quid you can sing what you like, you know. So yeah, it's not bad.
And I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now, fuck me.
Hang on. Can I bring them down to the sausage van in a bit? Right, thanks. Bye. That was Lee, that. He's got, where all the pole up down there for pizza, look. He's got a sausage van. He gives me a sausage every morning. But I'm trying to cut down because 5 sausages a week, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. By the end of the month, you're starting to put weight on, so try and only have a couple of weeks now, you know what I mean?
I suppose I could collect my books, get on back to school. Still, my daddy's cute.
I started doing it on my own, and I set all my gear up, and I just couldn't do it. Every time I went to sing the mic, I just couldn't do it. And in the end, I just thought, sod this, I'm going home. I started unplugging the stuff. And halfway through it, I just thought, no, I'm going to have a go of this. I was determined, so I sort of, well, oh, well, oh, well, you know, rave on. And one bloke come past, and he threw 10 pence in. And that 10 pence made me carry on. I know it's hard to believe, but I am pretty shy, mate. So when Tommy come, and Dave, and Ray, all this lunacy around me took the attention off me, which then let me concentrate on what I wanted to do. Without Tommy and Ray, and Dave when he was doing it was nothing.
The way you dance around on me tight, the way you kiss and say goodnight, rave on, crazy feeling, and I know you got me reeling when you say I love you.
Yeah, well, 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 you're on there. Oh, there they are, I'm Shameless. I know everybody in the shop, they're all right with me in here. They've always been sound with me. Bit of a godsend this sometimes. The only weather's really bad and snow, just get to come down and get a quick brew. During my official break, of course. Where to go, been pizza up now. And I'm gonna get me equipment out that I need. It's a very, very specialised job, this, what I do. And it takes a great deal of concentration. And, you know, it's really hard work. It's very, very technical. And you'll see me in a minute when I come out with my stuff.
See you later.
Yeah, here's my equipment. I told you it was a very technical job. And this is the guy that made me say, stop being a tight sod and go and buy yourself a sign. And it cost me 60 quid, and it's the best £60 I've ever invested.
Right. They're a fun band, aren't they? A bit of entertainment. Manchester needs entertainment on the street. It's a bit of street theatre, and I think that's what we've got with this band. Definitely. People like it, they love it, they have a laugh. People need that.
Gotta get a long shot of that. It's like the Grim Reaper, isn't it? You get one of them things on his back. Do you think you'll be starstruck when you see Liam Gallagher?
No. I've worked with people who are well known before. I've worked with Everly Brothers at the Domino Club for Jack McCall, Herman's Hermits. I've worked with a lot of people, quite a few people actually. I know quite a few people as well. When I was a kid, I had polio as a kid. I was covered in plaster for 2 years, like that. Which isn't funny, you know what I mean? Anyway, then I went into a wheelchair, from a wheelchair to bars on my leg. The kids were checking the mickey a little bit, unsympathetic, what they are. So I was walking past the bridge one day, took it off, threw it over the bridge, and never wore it since. And I just hear me dancing now, you know, so.
A summer day, sticky black tarmac, beat ducks in a park and...
It's like this guy said, what's it like to me? Because I said, the fame doesn't matter at all. It's not the fame that matters to me, it's performing. When I see people enjoying themselves, I'm dancing or giving it all this, you know, and then I see them all enjoying themselves. It's like when you get on a stage, the only way to describe it, it's like me stepping into another world.
Yeah, rocking all over the world.
We're going to Mother Max, aren't we? I played the harmonica there once for him on St Patrick's Day, you know. Nice pub, this, actually.
I've got a funny feeling that when we get to Parklife, you might suffer some sort of fucking stage fright.
Who?
You.
Me?
Mm.
That's actually funny. Because I was thinking that you would. If you didn't have a bit of nerve fright, then you wouldn't perform as good. All I'd be concerned about on that stage, right, is that we give our best and nothing goes wrong. You know what I mean? That's all I'm concerned about. I've never liked publicity. What happened?
All right, if you don't like publicity,
oh, yeah.
How come you've been on The X Factor, Britain's Got Talent, Jeremy Kyle,
yeah.
The Judge Rim, the show,
yeah.
Manchester Live Television.
I like that one, actually. When I saw the feedback to that, when he played it, when it was played
and
back.
And he looked like publicity.
I really want to know you. Really want to go with you.
There's a Parklife poster out there, but our name's not on it yet. I've asked Ollie out of the Parklife office, and he said that he's going to get us on it.
It should be on there, shouldn't it? It's probably people, been on it.
He's got people saying, oh, are you on the Parklife? I said, yeah, you're on the Parklife. Oh, you're not on the poster. You're not on the poster, you know. So.
Did you tell her that?
Yeah, no, Ollie's a man.
So, how do you feel about Parklife yourself?
I'm just going to check it as a normal show. What I tend to do, like when we was at Kendall Carling, when there was all those people there, I just looked into the microphone and didn't take much notice of the crowd. You know, when you start looking at the crowd and things like that, you're going to forget what you're doing. I might have a look at the crowd if we're getting near the end of the gig. And have a look round then, but not while I'm saying, I'll just concentrate on what I'm doing. Tommy's going to be dressed as a policeman. It's too late to change his image now. What, if his trousers are a bit long, instead of taking him to a tailor's or getting somebody to turn them up, he just gets a big pair of scissors and whacks fucking 6 inches off the end of him.
He looks forward to Saturday and coming down. You know, it gives him a sort of buzz, you know what I mean? I think that's good at his age. Instead of sitting around, most people would be sat around with their feet up, wouldn't they? But he gets out and, you know, I quite admire that.
Dorothy, you will be my girl forever, ever. I could one day the devil pass you away.
See you, mate. Take care. See you, love. Take care. See you, mate. See you, lads. Be good.
Yeah, look at this here. Think of one here.
I've put me hood up, I've got a fucking bad cold on my chest. If I sing this afternoon with this cold, I'll sound like fucking awful.
He's a nice guy, you know. I feel me and him.
How do you know him?
Oh, he's doing this in Piccadilly. He's a nice guy, he likes to have fun.
Oh, here's our bus. It takes a lot of guts to get up in front of an audience and do a show. It takes a lot of guts. And for people, it's like Simon Cowell. I told him off once, you know. Oh yes, I did. I was on Britain's Got Talent, and he said to this kid, "Get off the stage. You can't sing." I said, "Try and come over, mate." I said, "Hey, don't say that." I said, "She's got time to develop her voice. You know what I mean?" But he's a character, you know.
Yeah, you dirty rat. You dirty, dirty rat. I'm never going to get you clean, you dirty rat.
Yeah, we promise that any money that we take today, thank you, mate, will be to a very good cause. It'll be all spent on cigarettes and alcohol.
Impact, you know what I mean? I did a show not so long ago at the Queen of Hearts. You know the Queen of Hearts nightclub in Fellowfield area? Over 500 attended. She said it's the most they've ever come in, just to watch one person, you know. So, and the girls ripped my shirt off.
That's
no, I'm not joking, I'm not actually what joking. I'm not joking. I was dancing, and next minute, they all moved in on me. I don't know, this month I had to get off the stage. I thought all my pants don't go as well.
Oh, Maggie, I couldn't try anymore. You led me away from home, cause you didn't. I suppose I could collect my books, get on back to school.
Years ago, ain't that? Well, I've been with him now about 8 years. How long have you been with him?
I'm not far behind you.
No. You'll be fine, Tommy. It is a big event, and it's a big moment for you. When you step out on that stage, 140,000 people there, all you need to do is just do what you do, jump about and enjoy yourself. You know what I mean?
I'm so glad you're revealing your love for me.
No, you're thinking, out, Tom, what are you doing here? You're tying me up like fucking Houdini. Well, let me just tell you something now. You're going to get massive publicity here, and you deserve to get a lot of publicity. You're very well known in where is it again? I'm going down. I don't really know how to tell you this. It's like you're learning somebody how to play an harmonica. It's virtually impossible. But I could do it. I have helped one guy to learn. But then I think he had a mental breakdown. I'm only joking. I'm only joking. It's very difficult to tell people, you know, how to do it. But I've been doing it most of my life. I love what I do. Do you want me to play a tune? Raymond Boddington resident. What? I'm in Mother Max. Yeah, we are coming to Millstone, yeah. Why are you there? Have you got a place? Right, we're coming over now. I'm a fucking celebrity and I'm fucking walking in the fucking rain. You're more worried about the camera than me. Check the camera, let me get wet. Jim McDonald didn't get all it. But fucking hell. Remind me to buy you a fucking umbrella. Fuck off.
You alright now?
Yeah. Just pull the muscle of the leg a bit, you know.
It what?
Make sure that muscle won't pull. Yeah, you could freeze, I could freeze. They could freeze with the camera. Anybody can freeze.
Won't freeze.
But you won't freeze.
You know why we won't freeze?
No, because you'd be on fucking fire.
Because it's June.
That's when I get on the stage, I pull the muscle.
Yeah, you pull the muscle.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be pulling your muscle at your
age. I'm here, Roman, anyway.
I'd like to hand you over to the star of the show, Millstone today, Ray Boddington.
Young one, down with the young one. The young one shouldn't be afraid. Let love, I'll let you down, give me song. Ever be time, if you sing it.
What I'm gonna do, you said you're gonna get your balls out, aren't you? I'll kick them into the crowd. I've got all the beach balls.
Oh yeah. Why wait until tomorrow?
What do you think of them?
Tomorrow, sometimes gonna come. Hold on. There's a song to be sung every time. Finish the singing. Don't take it away, this guy. He's a good performer, top performer, good guitarist, good singer, one of the best I've heard for years. Real, he's a performer in his own right.
Why are you more famous than me?
I've been around a lot more than you. A bit older than you, yeah. Good to be together.
Let's have you on your fucking feet. Some people say the city is built on nothing more than canals, cotton, steam and coal. But I say it was built on Northern Soul, acid house and rock and roll, funk, rock. And today, Parklife have brought for you from the streets of Manchester to the main stage of Parklife, the Piccadilly Rats. Give it up.
We'll just pretend that we're on the street. You know, we start looking at the crowd and that, we might get a bit nervous, and you know, but so we're just going to see it as a normal day.
I never expected that this group would actually escalate to the extent that it has. You can't write it at all. You couldn't write this group. You couldn't write it.
I can imagine school kids in 20 years' time asking the teacher, "Sir, was the Piccadilly Rats real or was the actors?" And then imagine the teacher, "Oh no, there was proper numpties."
Well, welcome to Manchester, it's the Piccadilly Rats on the Parklife. Last night I met an angel. She was standing by my bed. She came a little closer and she touched me on my head. I've often thought of angels, but that angel made me cry. And we all have an angel. They're up there in the sky. They're there for you and me, my friend, and they will not let you die. You put your trust in angels, an angel will come to you. Put your trust in angels, an angel will see you through. Thought my life had ended, the time had passed me by. Then an angel came to visit me and the angel made me cry.